and it needs to be repented of it. This man says I'm a W-A-N-K-E-R. That's okay. I used to be, but now I don't do it anymore. Thank God. God can heal you. God can save you. God can set you free, friends, from all kinds of sin. Today, friends, sexual sin is being promoted in every man. We ought to be ashamed of it. But today we're proud of the thing we should be ashamed of, and ashamed of the thing we should be proud of. 60 years ago in this country or so, it used to be a crime to be involved in homosexual activity. Today it's a crime to say it's wrong. You see how man's laws change? Man's laws change all the time, but God's law never does. The Bible says God's word is forever settled in heaven. And if God says it's wrong, it'll be wrong for all of eternity. It doesn't matter how many people scream, scream and protest. Ryan can protest every day of his life, and so can all the planet put together. But God ain't changing his mind. He said, I'm the Lord and I do not change. God's not broken. We're the ones that are broken. And we ought to align ourselves with God's word. God's word is true. And in sexual ethics, God's word says sex should be between a man and a woman in a marriage relationship. That's the truth. And that's the truth that will set you free. That's why we preach the truth, because we want you to be free. We want you to be free from the slavery to your sexual lust and passion that are going to take you to a lost eternity. God's looking for some hard men, and the hardest man I ever met was the Lord Jesus. You know how hard he is? Jesus was as hard as nails. Jesus is as hard as nails. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There's a good hard man in Belfast. His name is Jesus. He's as hard as nails. He stretched out his arms on Calvary to take the nails in his hands for sin. Look at the mockery in these people's hearts as this man, sexually immoral and explicit in front of us, and everybody laughs at it. It just shows you the wickedness and the evil in the hearts of men. How sad. How terribly sad. Thank God, God can save the sinner. God can rescue you today. God can change your heart. God can give you a new start. That's why Jesus died on the cross, to instigate a new agreement, a Good Friday agreement. You see, the Good Friday agreement of God was instituted on Calvary. When Jesus died on the cross, he instituted the Good Friday agreement. That agreement was that any sinner, whether they're a Protestant sinner, whether they're a Catholic sinner, a Republican sinner, a Loyalist sinner, all could come to the Good Friday agreement that Jesus made on the cross. Repent of your sin. The blood will cover you, the blood will forgive you, and the blood will bring you true peace. Peace with God. You know, friends, that's the peace we need. We need peace with God, and then you'll get the peace of God. Many of you today are still in war. You're living in the past. You're still fighting. Today you're still at war with God, but God says, come and enjoy peace. Peace with God through the Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ the righteous. It's his blood that cleanses. It's the blood of Jesus Christ we need today. It's the blood of covenant, the blood of agreement, the blood of God's Son. That's why the blood of Jesus is vitally important for you today, sir. You need the blood to cover you from your sins. Be careful crossing the road. Yes, there's a danger, friend, that you could get knocked down. Death stalks us in every corner. But thank God, life is available for eternity through Jesus Christ our Lord. Choose life and not death. Choose Christ and not sin. Choose God today. Turn away from your sin. Turn toward God. Stay safe. Sanitize your heart. There's a deadly plague going about. It's called the angel of death. You need to be sanitized. You need to apply the blood. The blood of Jesus will sanitize your hearts. Put on a faith mask today and be safe. What should it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? That's the words of Jesus. That just means, what benefit is it to you, sir, if you get all the money and all the riches and all the wealth? If you get the biggest muscles in the world, if you get the most beauty in the world, if you know all that this world can offer, what good would it be to you if you died tonight in your sleep? What good would it be? Death is a reality. Just as much as you're living in a reality today, death is a reality for every one of us. God says we're broken. And if we're going to enter into eternal life, then we need to be rebuilt and fixed. God's looking for a few joiners. He wants you to join his church. God said, I will build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. What are you building today? Are you building the devil's kingdom? you're standing over there on the other side, if you're standing holding and promoting the